circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out. Hear the heart rhythmically pulsate, forcing the blood to circulate.
The circulatory system's composed of the heart and vessels through which blood flows. This vascular network, in fact, contains arteries, capillaries, and veins. The heart's a muscle that actually has four different chambers internally.
The cardiac septum lengthwise divides the heart into left and right sides.
The right side pumps venous blood, in fact, to the lungs' alveoli or air sacs. The left side simultaneously pumps blood from the lungs throughout the body. We'll trace both circuits and we'll begin with blood that's poor in oxygen. It's rich in carbon dioxide, which must be released to the air outside.
Circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out. Hear the heart rhythmically pulsate, forcing the blood to circulate.
CO2's a metabolic waste that leaves the cells and relocates to blood and capillaries that gets drained into venules, then larger veins. The VEKV, two veins, not one, bring the blood into the right atrium. The coronary sinus does the same with venous blood from cardiac veins. The atrium is in diastole and fills with blood easily. The tricuspid valve lets it flow to the right ventricle that's relaxed below.
As the atrium empties, keep in mind that some of the blood remains behind.
So the atrium will now contract, squeeze this blood out, and then relax. The ventricle fills, then powerfully ejects the blood in systole. Some blood's left behind after it contracts, which stays in the chamber when it's relaxed.
Circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out. Hear the heart rhythmically pulsate, forcing the blood to circulate.
The pulmonary circulation starts in the right ventricle of the heart. Now let's see how the blood moves from the right ventricle to each lung.
As blood leaves the ventricle, it flows through the semilunar valve, which opens to the pulmonary trunk, which splits and becomes the pulmonary arteries of the lungs. The blood flows through these arteries, then arterioles, then capillaries, which surround air sacs that are filled indeed with oxygen from the air we breathe. The oxygen moves into the capillaries. CO2 moves out simultaneously. It gets exhaled as we breathe out through the nose or through the mouth.
Circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out. Hear the heart rhythmically pulsate, forcing the blood to circulate. Circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out.
Now let's see what happens to the blood that picked up the O2.
The oxygenated blood now starts making its journey towards the left heart. It flows into venules that are drained by four pulmonary veins. They carry blood away from the lungs into the relaxed left atrium. The mitral valve lets it flow to the left ventricle that's relaxed below.
As the atrium empties, keep in mind that some of the blood remains behind. So the atrium will now contract. Squeeze this blood out and then relax.
The ventricle fills, then forcibly ejects the blood in systole. Some blood's left behind after it contracts, which stays in the chamber when it's relaxed.
Circulation's what we're talking about. Blood flows to the heart, which pumps it out. Hear the heart rhythmically pulsate, forcing the blood to circulate.
The systemic circulation starts in the left ventricle of the heart. Now let's see how the blood will be circulated systemically.
As blood leaves the ventricle, it flows through the semilunar valve, which opens to the aorta, whose arterial tree feeds the heart itself, and then the body. The blood flows through the arteries, then arterioles, then capillaries, which lie close to cell membranes, where substances are interchanged. Nutrients and O2 move to the cells. CO2 and waste move out as well. They enter the blood, which makes it start to the right atrium of the heart. The CO2 must be eliminated, and the blood must be reoxygenated. So the cycle continues and will repeat every time that our hearts beat.